Hello and good morning to one and all. I, Purnima, welcome you to my class. And children, we are going to continue the same lesson, the 100 dresses, part 1, written by Al Basso Easter. So she is the one, children, in this story she has in fact described her real experience of life. Now children, we all know that she was an American author who used to write story, short story for children. And children, this 100 dresses is based on her writer's real life experience as a girl who received Peggy hand-me-down dresses. Now children, I would like to share the theme of the story and some important points of the lesson. So the theme of the story, the 100 dresses, is based on Eleanor's real life experience. It is the story of a girl who received Peggy's hand-me-down dresses. She felt very guilty for not having defended the character Wanda in her real life. And just to children, to excuse her guilt and to encourage others to stand against those people who bully others, she has written this lesson. Okay. Now, I would like to revise children this point again, that the story conveys a racial discrimination. It is one of its ill of the society, which has an adverse effect, okay, or an adverse impact on the people. Okay, Wanda is a girl who faces discrimination when she goes to the school for two reasons. First of all, she is from the poor family, and secondly, children, she is a Polish immigrant who came to Chicago, and she was admitted to the school who in the USA. So there, the children who were the native or the citizenship of USA, they used to mock her, they used to insult her, they used to laugh at her. Now, Wanda Petronovsky is in the class. Now I start my story, I start my important points, okay, before the explanation of the story. So my first point is Wanda Petronovsky she comes in the class. Wanda Petronovsky sat in the seat next to the last seat in for last row in room number 13, which was their classroom. Children, where only boys who did not get good marks or who used to make fun of each and everything, only the roar of the laughter used to come from the back seat. Otherwise, the student who used to sit there, they did not concentrate on study. So Wanda Petronovsky sat on that seat. And the reason was that she was being mocked by her classmate, especially a girl whose name was Peggy. Okay, so she was being insulted by her because I told you for two reasons. She was from a poor family and Peggy was from the rich family. She thinks that it is her 100% right. She can insult and mock any student of the class as she is. Her financial condition is extremely good. Second thing, Wanda Petronovsky was a poor girl from the, she was an immigrant from Polish region of Europe, and they have come to settle in the United States. So they are not treated there in a very nice manner. All the immigrants were looked down by the people who were living in United States. Okay. Though Wanda chose to sit in the back seat because there was a reason for her, she was living in a colony which was full of mud. The roads were quite bumpy and full of mud, and when she used to walk from her home to the school, her feet used to get very dirty. A layer of dust was seen on her legs. Okay. And moreover, children, that colony where she was living was the colony for poor people. It was just almost like the slum area where the poor people live. So this was the reason she herself avoided. She did not like to get insulted. She thought if she will sit in the back seat, So nobody will pay attention to her. In this way, she would escape from being insulted from the girls like Peggy and Maddie. Okay, I already told you children in my previous video that there are three characters. Peggy, who always keep on insulted Wanda. Wanda is a girl who is a poor, but she is very intelligent and she is having a creative mind. Then children, it is believed that the writer, the authoress, Albessor is the girl whose name is Maddie, because she has shared here in the story that this is based on her real life experience, and she advises those, she felt guilty. Why children, she felt guilty? Because she herself was not very rich, and children, she has borrowed some old dresses from Peggy. So she know that if she will against Peggy, because she was every time bullying Wanda, the Peggy will tell in front of everybody that this is the dress which Maddie was wearing was given by her. So this led her to keep quiet. She could not open her mouth because of this reason. And children, she felt so much guilty that she had written this chapter to assuage her guilt and to encourage others to stand against the person who are being bullied. Now, Wanda is very quiet. My second point is Wanda is very quiet and lonely in the class. Nobody knows why she chooses to sit there. Okay, maybe because everybody mocked her and she did not want that everybody should gain attention as if she will sit there. Okay. Nobody really thought much about Wanda. Nobody cared about her when she was in the class or not in the class. Now, Wanda Petronowski, she was an object of fun. Everybody used to make fun of her. Everybody used to make laugh on her. Okay. And children, when Wanda was inside the class, but nobody was think when she was absent. Nobody even bothered to think that why she is not in the class. Maybe she might be ill or whatever the reason. Nobody used to take care of her. Okay. Now, children, Peggy always used to laugh at Wanda. She was the only one who start making, every time insult her, make fun of her. Okay. And this she does just to gain the popularity. She was not so bad by her heart, but just to gain the popularity, she was doing all this thing. Funny name. Wanda Petronowski name seems to be funny because they were students whose name were very simple, like Thomas, Smith or Ellen. And children, Wanda Petronowski, it was a very long name for them. So children, it was rather a very strange name for the children. Now, Wanda did not have friends in the class. She came to the school alone and she went from the school alone. And she always wore a faded blue colored dress. But it was clean, but it was not ironed properly. Peggy making fun of Wanda. Peggy would always try to make fun of Wanda in a most courteous manner. She would ask, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? Wanda would answer, 100. Then Peggy would ask in a teasing but polite manner, all silk, I bet. Wanda would reply that they were all silk and of all colors. Then before Wanda had gone very far, all the girls would burst into laughing and they would talk about her. What a story, they would say, meaning that she was telling a lie. They would begin ask Wanda teasingly, how many shoes? Wanda would reply, 60 pairs. Maddie, though she did not like Peggy teasing every time and bullying Wanda, but she was poor herself. She could not raise her voice against Wanda because children, she was wearing the dress given to her by Peggy, and she knew if she will stop Peggy to insult her, then Peggy would take revenge. What she will say? She would say that the dress which Maddie you are putting is given by me. So that's why children, she could not tell anything to Peggy. Okay, well, one day, children, Maddie began to wonder who was going to, there was a drawing and coloring contest in the class. All the girls took part, okay, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses. So children, what was the contest about? To design dresses. It was for girls. For boys, some other thing was there. Peggy was the one who was good in drawing, and everybody was expecting Peggy to win the prize. Children, when they entered the classroom, everybody thought that Peggy would win the prize, and they found that they were drawing all over the room. There must have been 100 of them, so 100 pieces of drawing were there all over the room. They were all lined up in a very nice manner. Miss Mason announced the winner. She told them that the girl who drew 100 designs, all different and in beautiful color, is the winner. Okay, and she is Wanda Petronowski. She was the winner of the girls' medal of this year. Wanda has been absent from school for some days and was not there to receive the prize. Miss Mason asked the children to file around to make a line and go through the room to see her beautiful drawing. Peggy and Maddie noticed that they particularly two blue and a green dresses which Wanda used to talk about were displayed there. And children, they were also wondering that Wanda is a very creative girl, but at the same time they were thinking that why she is not present in the school. Okay, so she was very children, they were worried, but then children, the class started, everybody forget about Wanda Petronowski. All right, so now I'm going to read the lesson. I'm going to do the explanation of the lesson, students. So we were in page number 64. Wanda Petronowski was not in her seat, but nobody, not even Peggy and Maddie, the girl who started all the fun, noticed her absence. Now children, this chapter is starting with this line that today Wanda Petronowski was not in her back seat, and all the girls, they have noticed this thing, especially Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun. Children, these two girls' name is especially mentioned here because they were the one who always used to make fun of Wanda Petronowski. Now, she used to sit in the last row in room 13. So, what was room 13? Actually, it was their classroom. The classroom of Wanda Petronowski, Peggy and Madeline. So, it was their class. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat. Now children, generally children, that seat, the back seat was occupied by the boys who did not get good marks. And children, the corner of the room where there was most scuffling of feet, most roar of laughter when anything funny was said. So when anything funny was said in the class, that was the back corner. From there, lot of roar of laughter used to be heard, and scuffling of feet can be seen. Scuffling means dragging of the feet. Wanda did not sit there because she was rough, and now children, and that was a place where lot of dirt and mud can be seen on the floor. Now, Wanda did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. On the contrary, she was very quiet and rarely said anything at all. Now, children, Wanda was not the girl who used to make fun of any other children. And she rather used to talk in children every time. She was, in fact, on the contrary, she was the girl who used to, children, be very quiet. And she rarely said anything to anyone. Nobody had even heard her laugh out loud. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crooked sort of a smile, but that was all. Nobody knew exactly why Venda sat in the seat. Now, children, nobody knew, children, why Venda sat in that seat. But maybe, children, Venda wanted to escape from those children who had bullied her. Okay, she wanted to stay from, she did not want to come to notice to those children, because she knew that if she will come in front of them, they will start teasing her, they will start insulting her. Okay, because she was a poor girl. She had only one dress. So, children, the time when they thought about Venda was outside of school hours at noon time, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before school began. So, children, the time when she was before school hour, when the school began, and after the school, where the whole group of two or three students and sometime even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the school yard. Then sometime, children, these students waited for Venda also to have fun with her. And exactly, it was not the fun, it was exactly bullying of Venda by Peggy, because she was rich and Venda was poor. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with other children who got good marks and who did not trace in a whole lot of mud, did notice that Venda was not there. Now, children, on Wednesday, on Monday, the competition took place. On Wednesday, they noticed that Venda is not there in her seat. Okay, the two great person, Peggy and Madeline, because they were the one who always started teasing Venda. Peggy was the most popular girl in school. So, children, Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. She was pretty, she had many pretty clothes, and her hair was curly. Now, Peggy was from a very rich family. She had pretty dresses, okay, and children, her hair was curly, and Maddie was her closest friend. Her best friend was Maddie. Okay, the reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Venda absent was because Venda had made them late to school. They had waited for Venda to have some fun with her, and she just had not come. Okay, children, so that day, they realized that Venda was not there in the school, it was not because they wanted to talk to her. It was actually, they wanted to make fun of Venda, and they waited for a long time to insult her, but that day she was not to be seen. They often waited for Venda Petronovsky to have fun with her. So, children, whenever they feel like insulting her, they always stand and wait for Venda to make fun of her. So, children, this was the case with Maddie and Madeline. She used to support her. Though by heart, children, two things I would like to say here, that Peggy was not that bad girl. She only wanted to gain popularity. And Venda, this Madeline, she was only supporting her friend because she used to get some old dresses from Peggy. So she could not open her mouth against Peggy. And Madeline is supposed to be the writer here. Student, now we are here at page number 65. Question and answer we can discuss later after explanation of the chapter. Okay. Now, Venda Petronovsky, most of the children in room 13 did not have dance neglect. Now, children, something else is written by the writer, that why she attracted everybody, because children, her name was very long and peculiar. Venda Petronovsky, most of the children in room 13, what was room 13, children, it was their classroom, did not have names so long name like Venda. They had names easy to say. So they were having children names which was very short and easy to say, like Thomas, Smith or Alan. There was one boy named Bounce, Willie Bounce. And people thought that was funny. Only one boy named who was in the class whose name was Billy Bounce. And children, people thought that is most funniest name. But not funny in the same way that Petronovsky was. Venda did not have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that did not hang right. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She did not have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her just to enjoy, just to make fun of her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. "Venda," Peggy would say in a most courteous way. Children, Peggy would not insult her in a rude manner. This Peggy, just because she wanted to gain the popularity, she would never like to, children, hurt her in a rude manner, but in a very courteous and polite manner. So that's what written in the last paragraph of page 65. "Venda," Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. "Venda," she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge. What is the meaning of nudge? A gentle push like this, like from the elbow, we push our friend. So that is a nudge. "Tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up on your closet?" So children, just to make her make fun of her poverty, make fun of her blue color dress, children, she would ask that how many dresses you have in your closet. Closet is a cupboard. "100, Venda would say." So Venda would say what? A hundred, exclaimed all the little girls incredulously, and the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. Now the moment she used to say 100 dresses, all the girls will look at her, children, incredulously. Incredulously means showing unwillingness to believe. And children, the little girls who were playing hopscotch, they would stop playing for a while and they would listen to Venda Petrona speak. So children, this was the situation, and Venda, just to hide her poverty, even she used to say in a very nice manner 100. The moment she used to say 100, all the girls used to look at her incredulously. So what is the meaning of incredulously? Showing unwillingness to believe. "Yeah, 100 dresses all lined up," said Venda. And Venda would start saying again, "Yes, 100 dresses which is kept in line." Then her thin lips grew together in silence. And children, afterwards she used to become quiet because she knew that she was being insulted by Peggy. "What are they like? All silk, I bet," said Peggy. Now children, Peggy used to ask her, "Are they are of silk?" Because silk is the most expensive clothes. "Well, all silk, all color." "Velvet too?" "Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses," Venda would repeat stolidity. Stolidity means not showing any feeling. So again she used to make fun of her. "Are your dresses are of silk?" Venda used to say, "Yes, silk, and I have got different color dresses." At the same time she used to say, Peggy used again comment her that, "Is it of velvet too?" Again, velvet is an expensive clothes. So she said, "Yes, of velvet also. And all together, I've got 100 dresses and they're all lined up in my closet." Then they would let her go, and then before she would gone very far, they could not help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. And children, then she used to keep quiet. Venda, she used to get hurt. She used to move away from them. And the moment she used to go far, all the girls used to laugh at her loudly. 100 dresses. Obviously, the only dresses Venda had was the blue one she wore every day. Now, children, all the children was looking at her dress. She had only one dress till now she was wearing, and that was of blue color, and it was, children, faded. And that blue color dress she wore every day. So why did she said she had 100? What a story. "How many shoes did you say you had?" 60 pairs. She used to say, "I'm having 60 pair of shoes, all lined up in my closet." Angela. Sometimes she was insulted by Peggy. She used to ask how many shoes you are having, and she used to say, I'm having 60 pairs of shoes all lying in my closet. Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. All alike? Oh no, every pair is different. All colors, all lined up. Again, children, they used to pass comment that all the shoes are alike. That means the design of the shoes are almost the same, she told. No, I've got different designs of shoes. And I have, children, not only different designs of shoes, of different color shoes also. And they are all lined up. So, Peggy, who had thought of this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the last to leave. So, children, after making fun, the girl used to laugh at Brenda when she used to leave. And the, finally, children, at last, Peggy and her friend used to leave. Finally, Brenda would move up to the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder. Every now and then, in the funny way she had, finishing the walk to school alone. Angela, she, poor girl, she used to walk alone with a very sad mood, with her shoulder tilted. Okay, and she could not bear the insult every often which Peggy used to do to her. Now, children, here I'm going to read the last paragraph of page 66, and here, children, again, the Peggy is being supported by the writer by telling, she told that Peggy was not really cruel. Children, Peggy, though Peggy used to insult Brenda, she used to make fun of her, but she was not cruel. She protected small children from bullies. Now, children, she was the girl who used to protect small children when they were bullied by their classmates or from the elder children. Okay. So, children, and she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. And children, she was so kind-hearted that if some animal were mistreated, okay, so she used to take care of that animal and she used to cry for hours. If anybody had said to her, don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Brenda, she would have been very surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Now, children, many of the girls, even they try to tell Peggy that she is not behaving well with Brenda. It is very cruel on her part. So what she used to tell, why cruel on my part? Why she is lying that she is having 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that that was a lie. Anybody know that she is telling a lie, and that's why I have to do like that. Why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person. As why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. As for Maddie, this business of asking Brenda every day how many dresses and how many hairs and how many this and that she had was bothering her. Now, children, Maddie, though she was supporting children Peggy, but she did not was like that. Peggy, she could never ask Brenda that how many dresses she had, how many hats she had, how many pair of footwear she had, because children, there was reason behind that Maddie was poor herself. Maddie herself was poor. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down dresses. Hand-me-down dresses, children. She dresses which she was putting. It was hand-me-down dresses. Hand-me-down dresses, means, children, it was old clothes handed down by someone else. So, children, the dress which she was wearing, generally, children, it was handed down to her by Peggy. And that was the reason she could not raise her voice against Peggy. She knew that if she will open her mouth against Peggy, so Peggy would take revenge from her. Okay, so that was the reason she could not open her mouth against Peggy. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Brenda those questions in that mocking polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing herself. children, sometime when Peggy was asking Wanda those question in that mocking polite word, what is the meaning of mocking? Mocking here means, children, to make fun of someone. So when she used to make fun of Wanda in a very polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles. She would neglect, Maddie would neglect Wanda at that time, and she would study the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing herself. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda, exactly. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy hadn't invented the dresses game. Okay, she could not, she did not want to say anything to Wanda and neither Peggy. Okay, if Peggy hadn't invented the dresses game, but suppose Peggy and all the others started in on her next. Now, children, because she was feeling afraid, children, because the reality was that Maddie was from poor family and she was handed some dresses down by to her, given to her by Peggy, and that's why she thought if she will not hurt Wanda Petronsky, she might hurt her also by saying that she is having her old dresses and she was poor. Of course, she would have more sense than to say she had 100 dresses. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her, and nobody liked that somebody should bully her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Petronowski. But children, in her heart, Madeline always used to think and she always used to wish that Peggy should stop teasing Wanda Petronowski just because she had one dress. So children, with this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Goodbye.